This is the Nokia 2. Costing just under $100 here in the United States, it's the cheapest phone in the Nokia lineup. Nokia has never failed a durability test, but with a device this inexpensive, it'll be interesting to see what happens. This is the last phone I'll be testing before my 2017 Most Durable Smartphone Awards are posted, so let's hope it survives. Out of the box, the phone feels very solid. It's got the white and black Stormtrooper vibe going on, and even comes with a pair of headphones, which, you guessed it, plug right into the headphone jack at the top of the phone. With many companies making headphones an additional paid accessory, it's nice of Nokia to toss a pair in. The back of the phone is removable, which gives us access to the SIM and SD card trays, but no access to the huge 4100 mAh battery. Non-removable batteries have been the theme lately across all smartphones, and these Nokias are no different. The scratch test is first. With a phone this cheap, I was almost expecting a plastic screen, but it's actually advertised as Gorilla Glass 3. It is registering at a level 6 on most scale of hardness, along with the rest of the tempered glass smartphone flagships. So far, so good. The front 5-megapixel camera is under the same front glass. There is no home button or fingerprint scanner, so you'll have to unlock the phone manually. But for the amount of money you saved buying this device, it's really not a big deal. The earpiece is a super thin white piece of vinyl that isn't going to be doing much protection against dirt or metal shavings. The whole thing can be pulled right out from inside the phone, which means a year or two down the road, it could very well be falling out on its own. Glue doesn't last forever. The Nokia logo on the back of the phone is inlaid into the white plastic surface, very similar to how the old Nexus logos were set in place. These are secure at the moment, but they do come out. I imagine that over time, the thermal expansion and contraction of the plastic against the metal lettering will cause the lettering to come loose and fall out. Definitely not a deal breaker, but it might bug a few people aesthetically a year from now. Surprisingly, the 8-megapixel rear camera lens is made from glass. The Nokia 3, one step up from the Nokia 2, used inferior plastic, which can get damaged easily. Thumbs up for the cheaper Nokia 2 having better materials. I've tested an insane amount of phones on my channel this year. After this Nokia 2 test is over, I'll go back through all my phones and pick the most durable smartphone, the most repairable smartphone, and the least repairable. And I'll also throw some shade at companies who made some stupid design choices this year. Hopefully this information I provide helps people when buying phones. I know this snowman carved into the white plastic definitely approves of buying durable phones that stand the test of time. The buttons along the side are made from metal, along with the sides of the phone. Definitely all metal. Up here at the top of the phone, we have our headphone jack and some more metal. And the bottom of the phone. Instead of a USB-C, we have the older style micro USB connector. For 100 bucks though, you can't be too picky. And now for the burn test. This 5-inch IPS LCD lasted about 5 seconds under the heat from my flame. I do the burn test because, well, I wasn't allowed to play with matches as a child, and I'm making up for lost time. Plus, it's fun to watch pixels come back to life with the IPS displays, and don't pretend like you don't enjoy it as well. Now for the ultimate test to see what kind of build quality we get with $100 of materials. Starting from the back, we get a decent size flex from the phone, but the frame and the glass are still intact. A permanent kink has developed in the frame, but with a little bend from the front side, it flexes again the other direction. But the whole thing remains in one piece, which is pretty impressive. Even Nokia's cheapest phones are unbreakable. I'm a fan, and I'm definitely looking forward to what they come up with next year. Nokia's reputation is consistent. Hit that subscribe button so you don't miss the most durable smartphone awards for this year. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.